The Ben Harris-created origin series Young Wallander differs significantly from other television offerings. Two origin series that spring to mind are ITV's Endeavour and HBO's Perry Mason. Endeavour and Perry Mason are both period dramas which set up a pre-existing character. The ITV series, originally set in the 1960s, is the prequel to Inspector Morse. HBO's drama, set during the early 1930s, reveals how Perry Mason becomes the defense attorney we see in the 1950s series. That's the rub. Young Wallander, a present-day set production, isn't a period drama revolving around a previously established character. Young Wallander stars Adam Pålsson as Kurt Wallander. Further to Pålsson, with a significantly diverse cast, Young Wallander also stars Leanne Best, Richard Dillane, Ellise Chappell, Sara Seyed, Yasen Atour, Jordan Adene, Kiza Deen, Alan Emrys, Charles Mnene, and Clare Perkins. Malmo is a much darker and more sinister place than the city we see in Faceless Murderer, Wallander, and the British Wallander reboot. Wallander, in the first episode, is working in a distinctly more diverse police station environment than previous productions. This reality, not only short-lived, is somewhat misleading. Wallander's loyalty to his friends is tested significantly. Reza Al-Rahman, Wallander's partner and best friend, has his new promotion taken away by Detective Superintendent Hemberg and given to Kurt. The way Reza is treated, with it reeking of institutional police racism, is completely unacceptable. The issue, brushed over with a single line from Frieda Rask, isn't fully addressed in the manner one would expect. Hemberg, not caring about the optics, simply ignores Frieda's concerns. Even though the first episode establishes a diverse cast, by the time we get to the second installment, minority characters have already been metaphorically relegated to the second and third divisions. This unsurprisingly includes, except for possibly Frieda, female characters. The series doesn't come close to passing the Bechdel test. The six-episode first series offering, made available on Netflix Thursday, the 3rd of September, 2020, ticks off Wallander's familiar traits as if Pålsson is wandering around a Waitrose supermarket doing his weekly shopping. Wallander's musical tastes, something I can personally relate to, includes classical French composer Verdi. His increasing reliance on alcohol, something this character has in common with Sean Evans's Endeavour Morse, could be problematic. The Swedish landscape, every bit as much a character in the series as the acting talent, adds an ineffable quality to Young Wallander. If this series makes you want to visit Sweden, something you should know before buying your tickets, you're not going to see these landscapes. Young Wallander was filmed in and around Lithuania's Vilnius. The character's observational skills are reminiscent of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle's Sherlock Holmes. Holmes, in Sherlock and Elementary, is respectively played by Benedict Cumberbatch and Johnny Lee Miller. James Roday Rodriguez is Sean Spencer, Psych, and Tony Shalhoub's Adrian Monk, in referencing exceptional observational skills, springs to mind.